Hello students, today we will learn about interaction between drugs, nutrients and nutritional status. In this topic, we will learn about different kinds of food and drug interactions, various types of food and drug interactions, nutritional status due to food and drug interactions, and then we will summarize and conclude. Medicines can treat and cure many health problems. However, they must be taken properly to ensure that they are safe and effective. Medication should be extremely specific in their effects, have the same predictable effect for all patients, never be affected by concomitant food or other medications, exhibit linear potency, be totally non-toxic in any dosage, and require only a single dose to effect a permanent cure. However, this ideal drug is still to be discovered. We don't have a drug like that. Many medicines have powerful ingredients that interact with human body in different ways. Diet and lifestyle can sometimes have a significant impact on the drugs. A drug interaction is a situation in which a substance affects the activity of the drug. That is, the effects are increased or decreased, or they produce a new effect that neither produces on its own. Typically, interactions between drugs are known as drug-drug interaction. However, interactions may also exist between drugs and foods, and they are called as drug-food interactions or food and drug interactions. We also have drugs and herb interactions, and they are called as drug-herb interactions. Now, these three types of drug and drug interactions, food and drug interactions, or herb and drug interactions may occur out of accidental misuse or due to lack of knowledge about active ingredients which are involved in the relevant substances. Interactions between foods and drugs may inadvertently reduce or increase the drug effect. Some commonly used herbs, fruits, as well as alcohol may cause failure of therapy up to a point of very serious alterations in the patient's health. The majority of clinical relevant food and drug interactions are caused by food-induced changes in the bioavailability of the drug. Major side effects of some diet or drugs include alteration in absorption by fatty or high protein or high fiber diets. Bioavailability is an important pharmacokinetic parameter which is correlated with clinical effect of most of the drugs. However, in order to evaluate the clinical relevance of a food and drug interaction, the impact of food intake on the clinical effect of the drug has to be quantified as well. The most important interactions are those which are associated with high risk treatment failure arising from a significantly reduced bioavailability in a fed state. Such interactions are frequently caused by chelation with components in the food. In addition, the physiological response to food intake, in particular gastric acid secretion, may reduce or increase the bioavailability of certain drugs. Drug interactions can alter pharmacokinetics or pharmacodynamics of a drug. Let us learn what pharmacokinetics and what pharmacodynamics is. Drug interactions can alter pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics of a drug. The pharmacodynamic interaction may be additive, synergistic, or antagonistic effects of a drug. Drug interactions, they represent an important and widely under-recognized source of medication errors. The gastrointestinal absorption of drugs may be affected by the concurrent use of other agents that have a large surface area upon which the drug can be absorbed, bound, or chelated, or alter the gastric pH, alter the gastrointestinal motility, or affect the transport protein such as P-glycoprotein. A reduction only in absorption rate of a drug is seldom clinically important, whereas the reduction in extent of absorption will be clinically important if it results in subtherapeutic serum levels. Factors like non-specific binding, atypical kinetics, poor effector solubility, varying ratios of accessory proteins may alter kinetic behavior of an enzyme and subsequently confound the extrapolation of in vitro data to human situation. Coenzyme Q10 is very widely consumed by humans as a food supplement because of its recognition by public as a very important nutrient in supporting human health. But it interferes with intestinal efflux, transporter P glycoprotein, and as a result, food and drug interaction arise. The interaction of natural products and drugs is a common hidden problem encountered in clinical practice. The interactions between natural products and drugs are based on the same pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic principles as drug and drug interactions. Several fruits and berries have recently been shown to contain different kinds of agents that affect drug metabolizing enzymes. Grapefruit is a very important, well-known example, but also Sevillian orange, pomelo, and star fruit, all these fruits contain agents that inhibit cytochrome P450, which is the most important enzyme in drug metabolism. Students, the study of drug and drug, food and drug, herb and drug interactions, and the genetic factors which affects the pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics is expected to improve the drug safety and will enable individualized drug therapy. Drugs can show their efficacy only if administered in appropriate quantity and with appropriate combination of drugs and foods and at appropriate time, which is very, very important. In contrast, the easy access to information on drug and drug interactions, information about food and drug interactions is not always available conveniently. It is a very difficult and complex problem to accurately determine the effects of food and nutrients on a particular drug. Therefore, today's topic students will aim to help the healthcare professionals, especially nutritionists, physicians, pharmacists and patients to become more knowledgeable about drug and food interactions. Now, let us learn about fruit juices. Among all the fruit juices, grapefruit juice. This possesses very high interaction with almost all types of drugs. This juice modifies the body's way of metabolizing the medication, affecting the liver's ability to work the drug through a person's system. Once there was a reported case of purpura associated with concomitant ingestion of cyclostazol, aspirin and grapefruit juice in a 79 years old man. His purpura disappeared upon cessation of the grapefruit juice, although his medication was not altered. The most probable cause of this purpura is an increase in the blood level of cyclostazol because of the inhibition of cyclostazol metabolism by the components of grapefruit juice. There are lots of reports which have documented drug interactions with grapefruit juice that occur via inhibition of cytochrome P450-3A enzymes. Furanocoumarins present in the grapefruit juice inhibit the intestinal cytochrome 3A4 and have been shown to increase the oral bioavailability of medications like felodipine, midazolam, cyclosporine and raise their concentrations above the toxic levels. Grapefruit juice is generally contraindicated to patients taking psychotropics. And it is advised to inform patients about the described interactions. The in vitro data suggests that compounds present in grapefruit juice are able to inhibit the P glycoprotein transport activity, modifying the disposition of drugs that are P glycoprotein substrates such as talinolol. The overall exposure of some drugs can be increased by more than fivefold when taken with grapefruit juice and increase the risk of adverse effect. With new anticonvulsants, serum iron and sodium need to be monitored. Additionally, users are advised to avoid drinking grapefruit juice within 1 to 2 hours of taking any kind of anticonvulsants. Furanocoumarins and the active bioflavonoids which are present in the grapefruit juice are also inhibitors of organic anion transporting polypeptide and when ingested concomitantly, they can reduce the oral bioavailability of the organic anion transporting polypeptide substrate fexofenadine. Then we have some cholesterol lowering agents like lovastatin, and this lovastatin should be taken with food to enhance gastrointestinal absorption and bioavailability. The absorption of rosuvastatin, which is another anti-hyperlipidemic agent, was significantly decreased in the fed state compared with in the fasting state, which suggests that rosuvastatin should be administered only on empty stomach. We have other antihypertensive agents like simvastatin, ezetimibe, pravastatin, fluvastatin, etc., which may be taken without regards to the food. However, high fiber diets may lower the efficacy of all these drugs. Concomitant administration of statins with food may alter statin pharmacokinetics or pharmacodynamics, which will increase the risk of adverse reaction such as myopathy, rhabdomyolysis, or reducing the pharmacological action. Consumption of pectin or oat bran together with lovastatin reduces absorption of the drug, while alcohol intake does not affect the efficacy and safety of fluvastatin treatment. This was about grapefruit. Students, let us now go ahead with the next drug, that is warfarin. Warfarin is commonly used to treat, prevent thromboembolic events. Patients taking warfarin are at a risk of interactions with dietary supplements, but yet approximately 30% use herbal or natural product supplements on a regular basis, and this is very hazardous. There is a possible interaction between increased dietary protein intake to raise the serum albumin levels or cytochrome P450 activity, and has been postulated as mechanisms for resulting decrease in the international normalized ratios. Today, whenever I am talking about international normalized ratios, I will talk, or I will call it as INR. Some vegetables like broccoli, Brussels sprouts, kale, parsley, spinach, and other leafy vegetables are very high in vitamin K. Eating large quantities or making sudden changes in the amounts eaten of these vegetables, it interferes with the effectiveness and safety of warfarin therapy. And eating charboiled foods. Charboiled foods are broiling foods such as meat over charcoal or any other fuel source until the edges are charred or grill marks are visible. Those are called as charboiled foods. Eating charboiled foods may decrease warfarin activity, whereas eating cooked onions may increase warfarin activity. Soy foods, they have been reported both to increase and decrease the warfarin activity. The combination of warfarin administration and cranberry juice is associated with an elevated INR, that is international normalized ratio. It elevates the INR without bleeding in elderly patients. This cranberry juice, it has a flavonoid which has been shown to induce, inhibit, or act as a substrate for biosynthesis of several cytochrome P450 isoenzymes. Specifically, cranberry juice may inhibit the activity of cytochrome 2C9, which is the primary isoenzyme involved in metabolism of S-warfarin. If warfarin sodium is ingested with green leafy vegetables, the hypoprothrombinemic effect of warfarin may be decreased and thromboembolic complications may develop. Let us now go to the next drug, that is monoamine oxidases. Where are these monoamine oxidases used? They are used for treatment of depression. Now, antidepressant activity of monoamine oxidase inhibitors, these are MAOIs. So, the antidepressant activity of MAOIs was initially noted only in 1950s. We never knew about it before. Although older monoamino oxidase inhibitors, that is MAOIs, are effective in the treatment of depressive disorders, they are underutilized in clinical practice because there are lots of concerns about interaction with tyramine containing foods. The tyramine containing foods are matured cheese, red wine, ripened bananas, yogurt, shrimp paste, and salami. They are capable of producing hypertensive crisis in patients taking MAOIs. So one has to be very careful when consuming MAOIs with tyramine rich foods. Students, let us now go with antihypertensive drugs. We will learn about the food and drug interactions with antihypertensive drugs. Any patient who is placed on antihypertensive drug will benefit from moderate sodium restricted diets. Propranolol serum levels may be increased if taken with rich protein food. A change in diet from high carbohydrate, low protein to low carbohydrate, high protein may result in increased oral clearance. Smoking may decrease its plasma levels by increasing its metabolism. The intestinal absorption of celiprolol, which is a beta blocker, this is inhibited when it is taken with orange juice. Hesperidin, which is present in orange juice, is responsible for the decreased absorption of celiprolol. The absorption of ACE inhibitors is increased when taken on empty stomach. Grapefruit juice increases the bioavailability of felodipine, which are a calcium channel blocker. Licorice extract, a common ingredient of dietary supplement, contains glycyrrhizine, which is a potent inhibitor of 11-beta-hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase, and this increases excess of cortisol and mineralocorticoid receptors, which cause sodium retention and potassium depletion. So, it may interfere with various medicines including antihypertensive and antiarrhythmic agents also. A high intake of licorice can cause hypermineralocorticoidism with sodium retention, potassium loss, edema, increased blood pressure and depression of renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system. Students, now let us go to the next drug category, which is antibiotics, which are extensively used nowadays. Now, these antibiotics are very widely prescribed in medical practice. Many of them induce or are subject to interactions that may diminish their anti-infectious efficiency and elicit toxic effects also. Food intake can influence the effectiveness of any kind of antibiotic. Avoid co-administration of antibiotics with milk products, which are rich sources of divalent ions such as calcium and magnesium, that complex with some kinds of antibiotics and prevent their absorption. The intake of dairy products, however, needs to be monitored and encouraged with appropriate consideration of specific antibiotics involved. Then casein and calcium, which is present in milk, it decreases the absorption of an antibiotic called as ciprofloxacin. Then let us go to the next antibiotic, that is azithromycin. Azithromycin absorption is decreased when taken with food, resulting in 43% reduction in the bioavailability. Tetracycline is another antibiotic which should be taken 1 hour before or 2 hours after meals and should never be taken with milk because it binds calcium and iron, forming insoluble chelates, and it will influence the bioavailability of the drug also. The effect of milk added to coffee or black tea on bioavailability of tetracycline was evaluated in some healthy individuals. And the study results showed that even a little quantity of milk containing extremely small amount of calcium severely impair the absorption of drug, so that the presence of the metal ion should be carefully controlled in order to avoid decreasing the availability of tetracycline. Then there are other food and drug interactions which may reduce the bioavailability of drugs taken after the meals. These are called as negative food effects. However, enteric coated tablets that starts to disintegrate when they reach the middle to lower region of small intestine could reduce the negative food effects. Results indicate that food and drug interactions were avoided by separating the main absorption site of drugs from that of the food components. Let us now proceed to analgesics and antipyretics. These are generally used to treat mild to moderate pain and fever. for rapid relief. Acetaminophen should be taken in an empty stomach because food may slow the body absorption of acetaminophen. Co-administration of acetaminophen with pectin delays its absorption and onset. Then we have some NSAIDs like ibuprofen, naproxen and others which can cause stomach irritation, and thus they should be taken with food or milk. But avoid or limit the use of alcohol, because chronic alcohol can increase the risk of liver damage or stomach bleeding also sometimes. The absorption of ibuprofen and oxycodone when given in combination tablet affects the concomitant ingestion of the food. Bronchodilators like theophylline, albuterol and epinephrine processes different effects with the food. The effect of food on theophylline medications can vary very widely. High fat meals may increase the amount of theophylline in the body, while high carbohydrate meals may decrease it. Avoid alcohol if taking theophylline medications because it can increase the risk of side effects such as nausea, vomiting, headache and irritability. Avoid eating or drinking large amounts of foods and beverages that contain caffeine. It is present in chocolates, colas, coffee and tea. Since this theophylline is a xanthine derivative and these substances also contain xanthine, it is very important to avoid eating or drinking large amount of foods which have got caffeine. So, large amount of these substances while taking theophylline will increase the risk of drug toxicity. Additionally, both oral bronchodilators and caffeine stimulate the central nervous system. Therefore, patients are advised not to consume such kind of caffeine stimulating substances. Then, consumption of grapefruit juice while taking theophylline increases the bioavailability, and monitoring of plasma theophylline levels in patients consuming grapefruit juice, and it is better and helpful in monitoring so that it will help in better management of the patient care. Students, after these drugs, let us now go to very common drug, that is antihistamines. What are the drugs which come as antihistamine drugs? They are fexofenadine, loratadine, rupatadine, cimetidine and cetirizine. These are all called as antihistamines. It is best to take prescription antihistamines on an empty stomach to increase their effectiveness. Rupatadine is commonly used for management of diseases with allergic inflammation conditions. Cimetidine is given with food to assist the maintenance of a therapeutic blood concentration. A fraction of cimetidine is absorbed in the presence of food, allowing the drug to be dissolved once the gut is cleared. Thus, therapeutic levels are maintained throughout the dosing intervals. Now, let us go to the next category of drugs. They are antitubercular drugs. Antitubercular drugs like isoniazid have been associated with tyramine and histamine interactions. Inhibition of monoamino oxidase and histaminase by isoniazid can cause significant drug and food interactions. Food greatly decreases isoniazide bioavailability also. Oleanolic acid, which is a triterpenoid which exists widely in the food, medicinal herbs and other plants, has antimycobacterial activity against Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And when administered with isoniazide, it exerts a very synergistic effect. High fat meals decrease the serum concentration of cycloserine, which is a bacteriostatic antitubercular drug, and it results in incomplete eradication of bacteria. Now, let us go to the most common drug group, antidiabetics. In antidiabetics, we have lots of categories again. Let us look into them. First one, glimepiride. Glimepiride is an antidiabetic and a new generation sulfonylurea, which is a derivative, and it should be administered with breakfast or the first main meal of the day. It has absolute bioavailability and the absence of food interaction guarantee highly reproducible pharmacokinetics. Immediate release glipizide should be taken 30 minutes before meal. However, extended release tablets should be taken with breakfast. the maximum effectiveness of acarbose, which is an alpha glucosidase inhibitor, is attained when the drug is taken immediately at the start of each meal, not half an hour before or after, because it delays the carbohydrate absorption by inhibiting the enzyme alpha glucosidase. Then, students, we are seeing that nowadays thyroid problem is extensively prevalent among lots of age groups, for which they take thyroxine, which is another group of drugs. Let us look into thyroxine. Recent evidence pointed out the role of gastric acid secretion on the subsequent intestinal absorption of thyroxine in relation with timing of the food ingestion as well as with pH impairment associated to frequent gastric disorders like Helicobacter pylori infection and gastric atrophy. Levothyroxine is a derivative of thyroxine. Grapefruit juice may slightly delay the absorption of levothyroxine, but it seems to have only a minor effect on its bioavailability. Accordingly, the clinical relevance of grapefruit juice and levothyroxine interaction is likely to be very, very small. Then we will go to the next category of drugs, that is anti-tumor drugs. Mercaptopurine is a purine analog which is used for acute lymphoblastic leukemia and chronic myelogenous leukemias. Since it is inactivated by xanthine oxidase, concurrent intake of substances containing xanthine oxidase may potentially reduce bioavailability of mercaptopurine. Cow's milk is known to contain high level of xanthooxidase. This interaction may be clinically significant, and therefore most patients should try to separate timing of taking mercaptopurine and drinking milk. Then, after looking into these food and drug interactions, let us now look into nutritional status. What happens to this nutritional status during the food and drug interactions? Nutrition can affect the body's response to drugs. Conversely, drugs can affect the body's nutrition. Foods can enhance, delay, or decrease the drug absorption. Foods impair absorption of many antibiotics. They can alter metabolism of drugs. For example, high protein diets can accelerate metabolism of certain drugs by stimulating the cytochrome P450. Eating grape juice can inhibit cytochrome P450, slowing metabolism of some drugs. Diets that alter bacterial flora may markedly affect the overall metabolism of certain drugs. Some foods affects the body's response to drugs. For example, tyramine, which is a component of cheese and a potent vasoconstrictor, can cause hypertensive crisis in some patients who are taking monoamine oxidase inhibitors and also eat cheese. Nutritional deficiencies can affect drug and metabolism. Severe energy protein deficiencies reduce the enzyme tissue concentration and may impair the response to drugs by reducing absorption or protein binding and cause liver dysfunction. Changes in the gastrointestinal tract can impair absorption and affect response to a drug. Deficiency of calcium, magnesium, or zinc may impair drug metabolism. Vitamin C deficiency decreases the activity of drug metabolizing enzymes, especially in elders. Many drugs affect the appetite, food absorption, and tissue metabolism. Some drugs increase the gastrointestinal motility, decreasing the food absorption. Other drugs decrease the gastrointestinal motility. Some drugs are better tolerated if taken with food. Certain drugs, they affect the mineral metabolism. For example, diuretics and corticosteroids can deplete the body potassium, increasing susceptibility to digoxin-induced cardiac arrhythmias. Repeated use of laxatives may deplete potassium. Sulfonylureas and lithium can impair the uptake or release of iodine by thyroid. Oral contraceptives can lower the blood zinc levels and increase the copper levels. Certain antibiotics reduce iron absorption. Certain drugs affect vitamin absorption or metabolism. Ethanol impairs thymine utilization. Ethanol and oral contraceptive inhibits folate absorption, and most patients receiving phenytoin, phenobarbital, etc., they develop folic acid deficiency because hepatic microsomal drug metabolizing enzymes are affected. We also see malabsorption of vitamin B12 sometimes. This occurs because of use of amino salicylic acid, slow release potassium iodide, coclizine, trifluoroperazine, ethanol, and oral contraceptives. Oral contraceptives with a high progesterone dose can cause depression also, probably because of metabolically induced tryptophan deficiency. Now, after seeing all the drugs and food interactions and their effect on the nutritional status, let us now just conclude the topic. There are a large number of drugs which are introduced every year. Food and drug interactions can produce negative effects in safety and efficacy of drug therapy as well as in nutritional status of the patient. Therefore, like food, drugs taken by mouth must be absorbed through the lining of the stomach or small intestine. Consequently, the presence of food in digestive tract may reduce absorption of a drug. Often, such kind of interaction can be avoided by taking the drug 1 hour before or 2 hours after eating. Like drugs, food are not tested as comprehensively, so they may interact with prescription, over-the-counter drugs, etc. It is always good to suggest patients to tell their doctors, nutritionists and pharmacists about their food intake and dietary supplements so that interactions can be avoided.